know, sometimes they ask me, what do I do it for? You see, I do it for the Jane Fondas, the Michelle Obamas, the Brandy Loves, the Sofia Vergaras, the Mrs. Incredibles, the Mrs. Incredible.
I'm Chase. I buy storage units at auctions with my two companions, and I show you what reality TV doesn't. Welcome to Chase Thriss.
Well, well, well. Welcome back to part three of our 11 units we bought for $820. It's now Monday, and we bought all the units last Wednesday. So we're creeping up on a week, all right? So today, we are going back to Indianapolis to pick up three units. And if you're new to the trilogy here, this is like the Lord of the Rings, pretty much, but it's for storage units. So we start out with phase one of getting all the storage units. It's the journey, all right? We're getting all the journey out of the way. And at the very, you know, middle of part three, we're getting to the climax of showing you all the stuff I got. And then we're going to the ending, all right? So without further ado, let's get in the old dually again. Go straight to Indy.
All right, this is locker 373.
Brother Taylor, you've seen him in my videos a long time. He always helps me. He's never actually opened one up for the first time, so you give him the honors opening this thing up.
Ready?
Yep. Wow, this thing's packed. I didn't think it was this packed. Oh, geez. Oh, man.
Another dolly.
Hey, I forgot about that, yeah. I was like, yeah, cool, sweet, another dolly. Yeah, man, God, this thing's packed. I forgot how packed this thing was. I thought it was like half full. My sunshade rack right here.
We just fucking shelves and shit though.
That's what I needed though. That's why I bought this one. I wanted the mannequins and I wanted the shelving. Paid 45 for this one. It's not bad, right?
I'll bring all my
Oh, what's that?
Bud Light.
It's a Bud Light thing? Super Bowl? Oh, that's like in 2 weeks. That's in 2 weeks, man. Which one is it? XLIX? Which is it? X is, I don't know. What's XLIX in Norman Rimmel's? Look at that big old cock ring right there. All right, so it's the next day. I'm out here unloading my trailer the rest of the way. We got some of the bigger stuff unloaded last night. We got back around like 6 o'clock at night. It was already dark, so I didn't really want to stay out here very long and unload a bunch of stuff. So I went home, and right now it's the afternoon. And this right here, even though we're not done getting all of our storage units, we have one sectional sofa left to get in Lafayette, and then all the tires down there in Indianapolis. But this begins the selling phase, okay? So as we get all these units like together, we're closing in on getting all the units done. We're gonna start selling stuff off. So I listed my washer and dryer combo over there today or last night. Selling that in about 30 minutes or so when they get here for $450. So the whole process is a time proven tactic, okay? So we start in the phase where we get all the storage units, right? We unload them all into the warehouse. And as we're doing that, the last few units we can have a little leeway on. We start selling the big furniture, the most expensive furniture, and getting out of the way. That way we have a little bit of leeway and some money and space to keep going, okay? So my rent was due yesterday and I don't have enough money to cover it. So these right here and then that will cover my rent. So that's perfect. My rent's $600. And I didn't have much of my name just yesterday or today. So the $450 for the washer and dryer combo. And then, you know, a couple little tiny things here and there for a couple hundred dollars a piece will cover the rent. So I'll be good on that so I can keep moving forward. Now, so that's the second phase. And the third phase is selling all the little tiny little things, bigger, you know, ish big things on eBay. So the really high value stuff that you can't sell in the market, like on Facebook, because I don't like Facebook at all. I just sell the bigger things on Facebook to get rid of them really quickly And then the smaller to bigger medium-sized things that are worth a lot of money will start selling on eBay. And then that phase will phase out, all right, until the end of the month where we get to the next auction. And then we go buy all the units again, and then we start from phase one, getting units, selling bigger items, selling smaller items, okay? So that's how it all works out in my planning, how I run my warehouse. So that's why when you see my eBay hasn't moved for weeks, because I'm in the phase one or phase two, right? We're going through everything and we're selling off big stuff, right? So we found all the receipts to all this nice furniture out of the one unit in West Lafayette. And three of the pieces we have here are Sofia Vergara, all right? On that bed behind you, that's got king size bed, just the mattress alone was $21.99. The bed frame was $5.49. Now I'm selling both of those for $400, the bed and the bed frame. Seems like a good deal to me, $2,700 compared to $400. Yeah, and it's almost practically brand new. This couch behind me was a $1,400 couch, right? So selling it for $400 today, not a bad deal. The this table to my right over here was, $1,119. And yeah, I'm selling that for $350. So you see, we have a grand total. They spent $4,466 on all this furniture I got out of the storage unit. And that was just one of the units we got out of our 11, and I paid $220 for this unit, right? So not a bad return on investment.
How you doing?
How's it going, man?
Good. Here for the couch, right?
What's that?
Here for the couch? No, you guys are the, okay.
Yeah.
I thought you guys were really early. Okay. You see any good furniture you can restore? There's some more over here too. I haven't got over here to you, over here yet. 50. It's antique. All right, yep. I'll be having more in this month.
Thank you, man.
Yep, have a good one. How are we doing? Good. That's why I need four-wheel drive out here.
Yeah, I can see that. I was like, yep.
You guys are the lucky winners. When I put this stuff on here, sometimes I get hundreds of people asking for it, so. Okay. I think you were the first ones.
Oh, okay.
Here they are. They're a really nice set.
Okay. Well, mine just conked out literally, and I was like, for the last 3 days, I've been looking, so.
Okay.
I had a few people not message me back because I'm sure I was in a line of people. So.
Oh, I think I have 100 people that haven't messaged back. I can't get around to everyone.
Yeah.
I buy storage units. This is my warehouse. I put everything in.
Oh, cool.
I start finally selling. I got 11 units last Wednesday and this came out of one of them, you know.
Well, let me know when you get a second one. Well, besides white.
I'm picking one up today, actually.
Oh. If it's brown, let me know.
I think it is. It's a brown leather one. It's okay. Usually on a sectional, I just sell for 200 flat, okay. Pretty much. It's a pretty decent sectional. They go really fast for 200 flat.
It's all white furniture. It's really light though.
Oh, those adjust too right there?
Or is it? Oh, it's
yeah,
multiple
they
pieces?
Three pieces,
oh,
yeah.
That's easy. Cakewalk.
Oh, dude. That's really nice couch.
Yeah.
You
want
to
do it and with if you want piece? That, I'll throw this in there with it.
Kind
of matches it.
You ready?
Yeah. Whew. All right, so, oh my God, it's cold out here. It's supposed to be the negatives all week. Not looking forward to being out here. I won't be out here very long, I can tell you that. Anyways, we're almost done selling all the furniture. We have 5 pieces left, which about $800 worth of furniture left, okay? So anyways, going to these scooters, if you remember from the trilogy from the last episode 2, we got 38 of these bad boys, okay? As part of our 11 units, we paid $225 for them. So they've been sitting over there, you know, eyeballing me because I haven't got around to them yet. And today we're taking some apart, but I do have some details to show you right over here. All right, so the spin scooters here, they're technically a Segway ES4. The model number is SNCN 1.0. I paid $225 for 38 scooters. The investment in each scooter is currently at $6. Now, I've been emailing back and forth a few guys that are kind of experts in these. I don't want to say experts in scooters, but they're more savvy than I am when it comes to these types of scooters. I asked him for the selling price of what he would sell them for. He said about $450 to $500, so I just naturally went down to $400 a piece because I sell my stuff cheap and fast, and that puts me at a $15,400 price range for all 38 scooters. Now, you take 8 scooters away, it's around $12,000, okay? So the reason I took 8 scooters away is because a couple of them can't, I had to do a lot of work to them to sell them, and some of them are just wrecked. I mean, they're just destroyed. They need to be like, just, you know, parted out basically. Now these are $12,000 for 8. And the other couple scooters I have, the reason I took 8 of them away is because I know 2 of them are trashed and they need to be just completely parted out. And the other 6, I don't have 6 right here. I have 4 or 5 of them. Well, that's 6 right there. The other 6 I'm gonna offer on eBay. Before I do anything to them, without testing them or anything, I'm going to be offering for $250 to anyone watching this. Now they sell for $400, and I'll be offering a 20% coupon down below in the description that only people that can watch my YouTube videos can use. If you really want one of these scooters fast, okay? So, I'll be offering 6 of them for sale at $200 a piece for your price. These scooters are not cheap, mind you. These scooters are the premium scooters that you could buy for $800 right out of the box, okay? So you can buy these right out of the box, $800. These are obviously used, kind of beat up ones. And the 6 that I'm offering, the only testing I'm gonna be doing on them, because I can't turn them on or anything, is going to be a roll test, and then, you know, make sure I have all the bells, whistles, everything on them, kickstands. I'll make sure that everything is present, but I can't guarantee that, you know, they work 100%. So the parts on here are pretty cheap to buy if you have to. But okay, so I'm offering those that anyone that's savvy enough to do it themselves, okay? There's a big process in doing this, and I can share you some of them in my next video, but I'm gonna put some links down below to a young fella who likes to do this kind of stuff, which I'm basically sending every single one. I have to take them all apart myself and send the controllers out to him so he can reprogram them to use as a civilian or, you know, residential scooter that's not a corporation one. Now, these are all bought legally out of a storage unit, so there's nothing stolen per se on any of these. And before I even send these out to you, these boxes that are on the front right here, this is called the lot device, right? So this is the lot device. This is what sits in the front of the scooter. This is basically the GPS, you know, it holds all the information for these particular scooters. So if they wanted to track you or whatever, they couldn't because they don't have this device, which I just took out of this other one right here. So these are the devices for the anti-theft devices or whatever you want to call them for these scooters right here. And I take them out before I even send them. Now, for me to send these out economically, these come apart in 3 pieces, right? So this piece attaches to the top up here, and I'll have maybe a little schematic for you guys. But if you're tech savvy enough to buy one of these as is right here, basically all the components are in this stem right here. So there's the original battery's in there, the controller's in there, and this is the external battery. So it was crazy enough, this external battery right here It's actually a $200 add-on, $250 add-on if you had a regular scooter. So this one makes them so damn expensive because they can go twice as long. The remaining 30 scooters I have, the process is long. That's why it's gonna take a few weeks. Inside this stem right here, this is right here is the main battery. This is the external battery. And then down here is gonna be the controller. Wait, no, it's flipped around. Battery, controller, external battery. So what I need to do for all 30 of these scooters, which is why it's taking a long time to do, is take this controller out of here, right? And then set it to the side and do that 38 more times, or 30 more times, since I'm selling the six. And then I send them all off to California, and the guy will take them apart, solder a new link inside there, but this is all in a video down below you can watch. The process seems a lot. I don't want to do it in the cold. I don't really want to do it at all. And he charges me $20 per scooter to do it. And a lot of the work's on my end, to be honest, taking them apart and then getting the controllers out, because these are a pain in the ass to take out. I just tried it on one at home this weekend and I wanted to cry. But he reprograms the computer, or the controller, I'm sorry, the speed controller, and then sends it back to me. I reinstall it, and then it's now a residential use scooter that can sell for $400. Okay, so that's enough about scooters. Let me divert your attention right over here. So this wall right here, it's accumulating. This is all clothing, okay? This is all the clothing I've kept to the side that I've had friends and family go through that are worth actually selling or doing something with. The rest of the clothes I use to donate to Goodwill right away. So this is actually an empty box. But all this clothing is really good. This is 11 storage units worth of clothing. And there's a bunch more through here. There's a bunch more. It's just over in the tables. These are just stacked full of clothing, and they're actually very good name brands. So usually clothing I get is just kind of, you know, jank. But there's Nike, there's Calvin Klein, there's a bunch more, Brooks Brothers, stuff like that. I'll show you some samples over here on the rack. For clothing, so you pull out this right here. This is Calvin Klein. It's a very nice piece. And this actually came from the $200 unit with all the white furniture that I've sold. So this unit is just providing me with so much good stuff. It's amazing. There is like three or four units I didn't even show because they're just so jank, and I just threw basically everything away or donated already. So some of these units are just from those. This is A dot buyer. I don't know, but it's a nice coat right here. There's a lot of good clothing through here, good jackets, just premium stuff, you know. We're still going through these things little by little bit. I mean, we had some people out here the other day going through stuff, and it just got so cold out here. Here's some more clothing right here, actually. I think I threw on the table right here. This actually is the Duke Blue Devils. The $40 price tag on here still. I mean, a lot of this stuff is just, you know, brand new price. This is True Religion, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, True Religion has a price tag of $80 or something like that on here. Something ridiculous I'd never pay. There's some other stuff. There's some Reebok right here. And this has a price tag of $95. It's ridiculous, I'm telling you. Brand new clothing just sitting on my table. And then we have over here, this is the table where, as we're going through stuff on my big tables over there, I just told everyone that was helping me, that if you find something really cool that's worth money or something, just throw it on this table right here, and then I'll go through it later. So there are some really cool items on here to go through, but that will be actually a later video because I'm not gonna do like a 50 or an hour long video of going through everything. It's just way too long, way too boring, and I lose half of you halfway through. So there's some really cool stuff. There's actually more clothing right here that's brand new. So there's some neat pieces through here. It's actually a music box right there. And can't wait to go through it with you guys later on. Now, some of you guys saw this in my very first video on the trilogy. There is that nice Time Warner piece right there. No idea what it's worth, but it's sitting there ready to go, you know. I have not put anything on eBay since we started here. Well, maybe a few things, but not a lot, right? Let's wrap this video up here. Now, other than the scooters that I'm gonna be pricing, it's gonna be close to $13,000 after everything when I sell the scooters, right? $13,000. Now I paid $820 for all 11 units. Now, it's hard to put a price on everything. We haven't been through everything. Now, I'm just gonna be rounding up because some of this furniture I'm selling is really high end, and I've already made, $1,500 off of them already. $1,500 plus a couple hundred more. Let's just keep it at $1,500 to be easy. Some of these clothes are gonna be, I can't put a price on these clothes. I don't sell them personally. But there's another couple, I would say, if I were to sell $500 in clothes, that's $2,000. Now, we also found 1 ounce of gold, which I haven't even shown you yet, really. And so that's another $1,000. It's all 14 karat and 10 karat. So that puts us at $3,000 so far. And all the extra crap that I haven't shown you that I just have laying around, that's worth money, that $100 here, $100 there, $50 there, it's gonna be close to another $2,000 to $3,000. This is what, $2,500. So that's $5,500 extra stuff. That's just being very conservative what I'm doing here. So we almost, I would say $18,500 of everything with the scooters for $13,000. So we almost, I would say 18K to 20K out of, let's round this up because of gas, from $1,000 investment. I wouldn't call that bad. I mean, it's gonna take a long time to sell most of this stuff, but $18,000 to $20,000 for $1,000 investment ain't too bad. And obviously it's gonna take a long time to sell everything, but I'm really excited about these numbers right here because I'm usually not anywhere close to that when I buy these units, right? So you've made it to the end of the trilogy. And I would say these 11 units were very profitable, as I just explained on the whiteboard, like a teacher does. Definitely excited about eStorage to get through the rest of it. We'll be having follow-up videos, obviously, on all this stuff I'm getting. But just so you, it takes a lot to make videos as you're selling stuff and going through them all and just kind of keeping it all under wraps. Now, we needed these 11 units to be good, so I'm really excited about it. We can keep going. And we have a lot of repairs to do in the truck and the trailer, and to keep going forward. So this money will help do that. And if you guys want the scooters, links down below. I have links down below for everything I just talked about. For the next week, 2 weeks, it's gonna be very cold out here. So I'll be taking some of these scooters home to work on them. That way we can get them out in time for sale. I will be selling a lot locally, and then I'll offer a few select ones online for sale. They have to be really good ones to sell online because I don't want somebody to screw me over when they say it doesn't work. And also, to ship these, you saw I had to take these apart basically. So in-person sales is gonna be the way to go for these. But I will have those online for sale, the 6 that I'm offering at the end of this video. They'll be up there for sale. Anyways, enough talking. Thanks guys for watching this trilogy I did. I hope you enjoy it. We have more auctions coming because they've started coming, rolling back in. So I started buying some more. Every month, U-Haul auction, I'll be doing videos, and I'm really enjoying doing them. And I really hope you enjoy watching them. And you guys stay safe out there, stay warm. And remember, fortune favors the bold. You gotta earn some bold shit, right? Yeah.